Every square foot of our building has something on it.
Inside Chardon High School are hallways filled with hope.
Literally thousands. There are cards, letters, banners, other gifts, artwork. You can see origami strung from the ceiling.
Expressions of love and support from all over Northeast Ohio and the world that have helped in students' healing.
Every child brings a different suitcase with them to school. And in that suitcase, or one child's suitcase might be filled with love and courage and strength. Another child might have a suitcase that was empty. These cards and letters, and some of those kids with the empty suitcases, might help fill that up to give them a little more strength.
While still hurting, the school invited the community inside Sunday so that they too could see the overwhelming amount of compassion and caring, and to also remember and to reflect on what happened there.
The three lockers of the children have been decorated with the same decoration, and the students have signed their autographs and messages inside those lockers.
Inside the cafeteria are freshly painted walls, and the lunch tables have been rearranged. But according to the district, it was the high school students that went back inside and put the table where Danny, Demetrius, and Russell once sat back in its original spot.
Eventually, the signs will come down and be memorialized as the school year moves forward.
Our students are excited about a lot of things. You know, it's graduation, it's prom, it's all these sort of fun. We don't want to deny our students the opportunity to do those things that they should celebrate. And so we think that transitioning the building back to the way it was before February 27th makes sense.
But what will remain in the hallways of Chardon High School is a message of hope and healing, one heartbeat that will never go away.
That heartbeat is about as strong as it could ever get. And again, seeing these items brings a tear to your eye, a lump in your throat, but it also gives you a sense of strength that we are going to get beyond this and we are going to restore the learning environment.
In Chardon, Melissa Reid, Fox 8 News.